Magnussen is very famous. His fame is gaining by every second week.
Every time there's a race, you know, he will be all over the websites. He will always take news stories because people really connect to him.
There was something completely new to Danes, and they really got electric about that one thing in Australia.
Look at the response from the crowd. Kevin Magnussen is third on his debut.
This is Roskilde. It's very much my home. Those are the old Viking ships. It's a very old Viking place, this.
Do you get a lot of attention from the people here?
Well, you know, I can't do really stupid things anymore.
Did you before?
Yeah, I did.
Did you?
You know, it's just as boys do, and they all know who I am as a Formula One driver and all that, but they don't scream, and it's not like Justin Bieber, you know.
He certainly is something that the younger part of Denmark is very proud of, because it's energy, it's dynamics, it's cars, obviously.
First of all, he has talent. He's a professional. He can really compete, you know. And then he's really aspirational for people in Denmark.
I think Danish people are very proud of being Danes. And I don't know that he realizes how big an effect it has on young kids of all ages, really.
Yeah, they can pull.
Yeah.
Oh. It's such a small country, and you know, I'm not one of the top drivers yet, and still there's probably, you know, in Spa there was probably more Danish flags than anything else.
When you were this age, you knew then that you wanted to be in Formula One?
I actually really, really believed that I was going to be a Formula One driver when I was, you know, their age. You know, I remember someone saying, you know, it's a cute dream you have, but you should aim higher in your life. And I said, I want to be a world champion in Formula One. It's quite a high goal.
Lige siden jeg startede med BMW Park som 2-årig, der har jeg altid troet på, at jeg bliver Formel 1 med.
Anytime anybody asked him, what do you want to be when you grow up, it was always racing driver. I can't remember him saying anything else.
Jeg tror, jeg skal, når jeg bliver 18, så skal jeg op i Formel 2. Det kan jeg godt tænke mig.
We started in front of Ford. I took over when he was 14 years old. So I had a plan, and that was, you know, getting a very good mental coach to take him all the way. And when I called him, he said, daughter, there's no way I'm going to work with a boy age 14. And after meeting with Kevin, he called me and he had to admire. I never thought that I would meet anyone like him.
Hvor lang tid har du kørt race nu?
8 år, sådan cirka.
men du er kun 9. Det er jo meget længe, du har kørt.
Ja. Yeah.
Kevin, we saw those incredible pictures of you in a little McLaren swimming around that have been beamed all over the world. How old were you then?
I was about 2 years old. very young. These kids, when I was at their age, I just loved driving. That's all I wanted to do. And it just, yeah, I remember it so well.
Have you been surprised how determined that he's been?
No, because that's been the same all the way through. Once he was at the track and he was getting into the go-kart or into the race car, his personality changes completely, and he's now focused on the job. And I think that's what makes him successful.
Since he was 4 years old, he had this, not just going to Formula One, as most drivers think they will be going to, but no, I want to become a world champion, and I want to drive for McLaren.
When I came up through Formula 3 and became a test driver for McLaren, and then, you know, 20 years later, Kevin came along and he gets his chance with McLaren. That's pretty fantastic.
McLaren had told me that a second year in World Series was my last shot to, you know, show that I can win the championship. And when I'd won the championship, I knew that next step was Formula 1. And I was putting a lot of pressure on Martin Whitmarsh to take me on.
And how do you do that? How do you put pressure on someone like Martin?
I just went up to him and said that, come on, you know, I can do it. Give me the seat. I'll do better than your guys.
Kevin Magnussen er klar til at træne
Magnussens fodspor. Kevin Magnussen er et af de mest eftertragtede.
Kevin Magnussen, søn af racerkøren Jan Magnussen.
Everybody was aware of his talent. It's been talking about his talent for years. But when he got the seat in Formula 1, I think everything just rose to the level that it is now. It's what you talk about if you go to, you know, family lunches. Then you talk about Formula One and Kevin Magnussen. You've never done that before.
This is a small nation. We're not used to having Formula One drivers. It's a lot of pressure on a young person, but he seems to manage that in a very impressive way.
Has Formula One been everything that you expected in your first year?
I'd say it's been a lot more. Every time I get in the car, it's such an unbelievable feeling, you know, to know that this is my car, you know, this is my seat, it's got my name on it. But then you go on track and it's just another racing car and you're just trying to win, you know, if all this Formula One thing disappears and it's just about winning. So that's why it's a bit frustrating at the moment. It's tough racing for a top team like McLaren, who is struggling. If you're racing with a middle team, you know, you wouldn't expect much.
And what's the situation now? Are you waiting for that call again to confirm for next year? Will you be a McLaren driver next season?
Yeah, I'm kind of waiting just to have word said, saying that you have the seat for next year. But you know, the best thing for me right now is just to try and focus on this season and do the best I can here. There's been ups and downs this season. I've had good moments, I've had some bad ones.
Look at Magnussen on the inside. No, he's hit Massa, Massa's over.
I've learned a lot, but it's also, you know, really, what can you say, character building, and it's really strengthening my, you know, my racing driver, you know. So I have, you know, a positive feeling that I'll be in a McLaren next year. But, you know, the best thing for me right now is just to try and focus on this season and do the best I can here.
Working with a person being the spirited, it's amazing.
He's representing a nation in a very nice manner. I think every Dane identifies with what he does, and they're putting their hopes behind him.
Even my friends, my age, they would follow the qualifying even more intensely now than they did before.
Well, Kevin Magnussen is by far the number one sports name in Denmark for the moment, and I think he has the same possibility and the same chance of being the number one ever.